Dear students, good morning all of you. Today, in this video, I will discuss about numerical pad of computer keyboard. At the last video, I discussed basic usage and basic keys which are used while working over computer. In that video, we learned about special keys, alphabet keys, number keys from the typing section. Now in this video we will learn about numpad. Here in this numpad we have some special keys here, which you can see these all are also known as a special keys. These all special keys are used for different function, various functions, or you can say these all special keys are used for their special works. Let's we have example one by one. Suppose if I talk about insert option, this is insert button. This insert button is used to insert something in your document. But remember one thing, you may see sometimes by mistake it might have been happened with you also, that suppose this insert button is pressed and now after, if you are typing something in your normal word processor program like Microsoft Word and other, you might have noticed that you are typing and the typing is taking place from the left side of the computer screen and the text which are from the right side of the computer screen, right side of the cursor, is automatically deleted. As the progress for typing goes on, the contents at the right side of the cursor gets deleted one by one. So this is the major function of insert. Next, after we will see about delete. This delete button is used to delete a character from right side of the cursor position. Suppose if I tell you here we have written apple and the cursor is just here. So if we will press delete button, the letter from right side will be deleted, means letter this P will be deleted. So normally I mean to tell you that delete option is used to delete a character from right side of the cursor position. And this delete button is also used to delete the objects, files, folders or other computer elements which are selected. Next we move to home button. This home button is used to bring your cursor to the home position. Suppose you are typing a letter and right now you are at the 15th line of your document. Cursor is available at the 15th line of the document. Now you want to move your cursor directly to the beginning of the page. So in that case you can use home button. This home button is used to bring your cursor to the home position of your document. End option. This end is just opposite of home. As recently we have understood that home brings the cursor position to the beginning, to the starting position of the document, whereas this end button will bring the cursor directly at the end position of the document. Suppose you are typing and you are right now at the 30th line of the document and then after for few seconds you move that cursor to the 10th line and then you want that cursor should be moved directly to the end of the line, directly to the end of the sentence, you can use this end button to bring your cursor to the end of the line, end of the sentence. Here you can see one option we have, page up. This page up option brings, sorry, this page up options helps you to scroll your page up one by one, whereas this page down option helps you to scroll your page down. If suppose the mouse is not working, but you have to move your page, you have to move your document up and down, in that case you can take help of page up button to scroll your page up and page down button to scroll your page down. So this is the major use of these all keys. So one by one we have understood about insert, home page up, delete, end, and page down. Now let's we understand about these cursor keys. These all are known as arrow keys. These all are known as arrow keys. These all arrow keys are used to control the movement of cursor in your document. Suppose here you can see, suppose first of all we are talking about the up arrow key. This up arrow key helps you to bring your cursor up, bring your cursor upward of the document. Here down, this arrow key will help you to move your cursor down in your document. This left arrow key will help you to bring your cursor to the left side of the document. I mean to tell you, suppose there are many words and cursor is at the one word, from that particular position, from that present position, if you want to move your cursor to left side, in that case you will use this left arrow key. But if you want to move the cursor to right of the current position, you have to use the right arrow key button. Here let's we have an example for our better understanding. Suppose I write here, I am a student of class 10. Suppose the cursor is right now here. So to bring the cursor just up of this line, you will use this upward key, arrow key. To bring this cursor to down of this line, you have to use this down arrow key. To bring this cursor to left of this word, toward left side of this sentence, you have to use this left arrow key. And if you want to move this cursor to right side of the text, you have to use this right arrow key. So I hope you understood these all keys, these all key functions smoothly, the special keys and this arrow keys. Now let's move to the number keypad. These all are known as number keypad, including 0. Here this keypad is used to type the numbers in your computer keyboard. But remember, when this num lock is on, then only this side of number keypad will work. Number keypad will be used as a number entry keys, otherwise it will not be active and it will not function as to type the numbers. So you have to check that if this num key light is lightening, it means num keypad is active. And now any of the keys from this num keypad will be used to type the numbers. Here you can turn on and turn off the num key using num lock keys available here. After this you find one of the special symbol keys here. These all are the special symbol keys. You can use these all keys in your mathematical calculations. After this we find one of the plus sign key. This plus sign key is used to type the plus sign in normal program, but if you are using this plus key in calculator, this will not be used as to type the normal character, but it will be used to find the addition of two numbers. and at the end you will find one of the key, that is enter key. This enter key is used to bring your cursor to the next line, and it is very similar in behavior that we have explained earlier in the previous video, which enter key is just similar in the alphabet keypad. Here one of the button you find del, D-E-L, and just above of this you find dot. This button is used to type the dot symbol, and when the numlock is off, this button will function as delete option, delete button. So in this way, I hope you understood these all keys functions, means you understood the normal functions, basic functions of the computer keyboard at the second part. And in this second part we discussed about the numpad of computer keyboard. So I hope you understood about the basic functions of numpad keyboard. That's all for this video. I see you in the next video. Have a good day.
Yes, sir. Yes.